Did you know the presence of moisture in a refrigeration system is a major cause of system failure? So in the event that all steps aren't properly carried out, moisture will enter in the system and cause problems both in the refrigeration system as well as the compressor. See below what can happen. In the refrigeration system capillary tube, clogging will occur due to residual moisture freezing in the small passage. So the capillary will be blocked and the refrigerator will stop operating properly and heat up. By unplugging the refrigerator, the ice that was blocking the capillary will melt and cause the refrigerator to operate again. However, when it starts working again, the capillary will freeze once more, generating an intermittent blocking and unblocking cycle of the capillary, which can compromise food quality and preservation. While in the compressor, other problems arising from the remaining moisture will be oxidation of metallic components and oil degradation from acid created by the water mixing with the oil. Oil degraded by moisture also loses its lubricity, forcing the compressor motor to work harder, as well as increasing the wear on components that require lubrication. In many cases, there's an increase in energy consumption, causing overheating and thermal protection cycles. In some cases, this can lead to motor harm or even a burnout. In other cases, it's common that the lack of lubrication can generate increased shaft, piston, and connecting rod wear, leading to compressor locking. Finally, the oil contaminated with moisture generates cylinder head and valve plate carbonization. For these reasons, it's essential that system maintenance is correctly carried out. Improper maintenance may even let the system work for some time, but certainly it will shorten the life of the compressor and/or refrigerator. So, when installing a compressor or doing maintenance that requires the pipe to be cut, requires opening the system, it's necessary to make sure that moisture is completely removed during the vacuum process. You already know that to ensure good system performance, you need to be sure the welding is done well. This will prevent gas from leaking and consequently moisture from entering the system. And also remember that changing the filter dryer and using good quality refrigerant are required. Finally, best practices should be followed during the vacuum process. For more information on how to properly perform this process, watch this video, Step by Step to Replace a Compressor, which is available on the Refrigeration Club website.